thoughts and intents of the heart, for by his hand they were all created from the beginning. Okay, so, Heavenly Father and Jesus Christ worked together to form man after their own image, in that we look, in that we have physical bodies that closely resemble Heavenly Father and Jesus Christ, and we have all the different things in us that make us people. And hence we became children of men after being born to earthly parents. And we had forgotten all. And we didn't know that we came from God unless we were taught it again. And we have to strike a delicate balance in all things, because if we become too holy and too puffed up about being a child of God, then we lose some of the spirit that God has sent to protect us and to guide us along our way. But if we become too worldly and too much like a child of man, then the spirit just disappears and our hearts are filled with things that it shouldn't be really filled of. I mean, you gotta strike a delicate balance. Yes, live in the world, but don't be worldly. I mean, it's your choice, of course. But you know what? Circumstance doesn't define who a person will be or can become. Because Heavenly Father, He created us, so He knows us. He knows our thoughts, He knows our intents, He knows our desires. And even though we may not be able to do things that show our good intent, Father knows that even if it's deep down inside of us, that each of us have a good intent or desire to do good. He knows when we want to do something for others but just can't, and we're being blessed for our thoughts and our intents of the heart. I mean, if all we can do is desire to believe, but we can't actively believe for whatever reason, we shall be blessed, and the Lord will give us that opportunity. Will give that opportunity to receive the gospel in its fullness. And He looketh down upon all of us with love, and Jesus Christ looked down upon us with love, and that's why He wanted to come and do the atonement for us, because He saw our potential from the beginning, from when we were created. And He wanted us to have the fullness of everything that was good and righteous. So He died for us that we might be able to do good and to live well and to be blessed continually, despite any mistakes we may make. That we could repent from our mistakes. I mean, just like children can say, I'm sorry, and do things to do better. We can say, I'm sorry, and do a process of repentance to do better when we do something wrong. And, I mean, the thoughts and intents of the heart are very powerful, because eventually thoughts materializes into words or actions. And we have to be careful with those, because it may come out differently than we anticipated. But as long as we intertwine our thoughts and our intents with the heart together, we can do something, we can do good things. Because thoughts can be impulsive, and they can really hurt people. But if we combine them with our good intents of the heart, we can really do something good to help another, whether we realize it or not. And by His hand we were created, by His loving hand. sacrifice of Christ be in vain, that we might not disappoint Heavenly Father, that we might use what they have given us to do good things, that our blessings will multiply. But it's everyone's choice what they wish to do. We are, that's one of our rights as children of God and children are meant to choose ourselves what we wish to do. But be mindful, what we choose comes with consequences that we cannot choose, only that we can accept. And with that said, I love you all so very much. You say these things humbly in the name.